I have just half an hour, and Philip didn't tell me that it will be public talk. Therefore, I am sorry for the formulas which you will see, which yesterday I was not yet able to clean up. Yeah. So, but you just don't pay attention to this thing. Now, let me start with some quotation. Okay, I never understood why the theory of relativity, with its concept and problems so far removed from practical life, should for so long have met with a lively or indeed passionate resonance among broad circles of the public. I have never yet heard any truly convincing answer to this question. How do you think to whom belongs this quote? Einstein, and he said it twice. Once in 43 and second time in 53. And why? Because, in fact, general relativity had not enough proof at this time. There was two things, okay, bending of light, advance of perihelion, and nothing. Real proof for general relativity came really with cosmology during the last 33 years. And the title of my talk is How Predictive Are Cosmological Theories. Yesterday, Jim Peebles told that he is against the word predictions in cosmology. And today, in the morning, I realized why he was against, because I forgot to put article there, predictions. You see, because Russians never know where to put right articles. But in this particular case, okay, I realized what is this. Now, let me start immediately with conclusions, because I know that Bill is a tough chairman. I'm a tough speaker, but he is maybe even tougher chairman. He will not allow me to go too far. And conclusion can be summarized in one slide. You see on the left side the picture, real picture, taken with electronic microscope of the hydrogen atom. And on the right side, you see the direct photograph of the universe when it was just 300,000 years old. You could say that it's baby universe, right? And you could ask, nevertheless, in one case, it goes about the scale 10 minus 8 centimeter. In the other case, it goes about the scales 13 billion light years. You could ask, what is in common? What is behind both of these pictures? And behind both of these pictures, besides of Einstein, is also Mr. Heisenberg with his uncertainty relation. And how do we know this thing? In fact, actually, my story is going to be a story of two marriages. First marriage, when it was 40 years ago, when I managed to marry some quantum theory with general relativity, okay, as a result was produced Cinderella. Why? Because there was no experimental confirmation for all this theory, which is called quantum origin of the universe structure. For second marriage, when Cinderella has grown and became 33 years old, you see, I have nothing to do with the second marriage, for that experimentalists are responsible who made really brilliant measurement during the last 23 years. And I think the final point was in 2013 when the Planck experiment result were released. Now, of course, you have to understand that we should be a little bit modest and remember, as Poincaré said once, there are no definitely solved problems. There are only more or less solved problems. And what I am going to tell you is about more or less solved problem. Also, one should not forget that we work in physics, yeah? And one of the main things in physics is, of course, experiment or observation which we should not undervalue. And it was realized long ago, because if you take nice, I think, best book on the history, The Decline and Fall of Roman Empire, Gibbon wrote there, the physics both of the Academy and the Liceo, as they are built, not on observations, but on argument, have retarded the progress of real knowledge. You see, so it's nonsense. And also Galileo said what is the difference between, for instance, politics and physics. He didn't mean politics, but he said that in questions of science, the authority of the thousands is not worth the humble reasoning of a single individual. The modern observations deprive all former writers of any authority. Therefore, we have really to be, okay, more concentrated on the measurement, not on the beauty of the theory, because, okay, recently people started to tell that theory should be right by definition because it's beautiful, but you understand that the concept of beauty depends on your personal, okay, understanding and on your personal test. Now, of course, to marry gravity with quantum mechanics and get success, we needed to assume something. Namely, we needed to assume that at the earliest stages of the universe evolution, there was dominating so-called dark energy. You perhaps all heard about the existence of dark energy. And you know that it's some kind of ingredient which produce anti-gravity, contrary to the normal gravity. And if you want to succeed, you have to use this ingredient, which today we do not know even why it's there. We have to use this ingredient very far away in past, because our universe is expanding, so we have to use it as the first fraction of the second after creation of the universe. This concept became known as cosmic inflation. All of you perhaps knows what is inflation, and sometimes inflation can be very useful, at least for some people. You see, but for the universe it was extremely useful because it allowed, first of all, to extract infinite amount of energy from gravitational reservoirs, and also it produced finally, the whole structure, I mean galaxies, planets, stars, and finally us also. All of us come from Heisenberg uncertainty relation. But I will use very simple, robust definition of what is this inflation, because for me, real cosmic inflation is not a theory, not a framework, it's the theory, when it's understood as a stage of unbroken accelerated expansion, when gravity acts like anti-gravity, and due to the same ingredient, which is responsible for quantum fluctuations. Otherwise, it's rubbish without any predictions. And here comes sociology. Okay, let me say a couple of words on sociology. Because in the case when I use just this definition, it's unbeatable as predictive theory because it allows us to calculate the effect of amplification of quantum fluctuations in completely controllable regime from the point of view of physics, while most of the alternatives cannot even compete with what I call rubbish inflation in the sense of controllable reproduction of outcome for quantum fluctuations. Now, let's take cosmology, extract from its theology, and what is inflation? Everything what we need is exponential expansion of the universe. When gravity acts like anti-gravity, you start with zero velocities, and then these velocities grow like... What happened? Perhaps somebody... Okay. Okay, good. Then... Forget about all this multiverse, God knows what, all philosophical questions, use just exponent, yeah? during last 74. As I say, what does it mean, EFOLD? EFOLD is the period during which the universe increased its size by factor 3, you see, roughly speaking. When I say 2 EFOLDs, once by factor 3, second time by factor 3. And then there is no problem with predictions which could falsify the theory, I say falsify in Popper sense. What really we need for the whole thing? What is relevant for these predictions? Energy density and pressure. And energy density and pressure should imitate what is called dark energy. But it should happen not today, but in past. During creation of the whole universe. You see, let me skip this kind of transparency because people who know, they know what is this. People who don't know, I will not be able to explain. And then also during this short time, which I got from Bill. But also, okay, let me go directly, okay, to the necessary requirement. Okay, this transparency means that pressure should be equal to minus energy density. You, of course, could say how it can be. But we know that it can be because we have today observation, what people call dark energy. You see, for a long time. Now if I take a lot of literature, which exists, thousands of papers, it's just attempt to reproduce this kind of equation of state using what people call scalar field potential whatsoever, doesn't matter what is this, and to show you how ugly it can be, I mean in sociology, let me show you two formulas, okay, or two potentials. When I see it, I am horrified. And why do you need all this, okay? Instead of doing this thing, you could do very simple thing. You could assume that in past, we had this stage of accelerated expansion, which was smooth, and you needed finally to get also graceful exit and produce universe like it's right now, because if there would be just cosmological constant, there would be no us, and we all would live in desert. Therefore, the whole theory can be parameterized by one number, okay, this index alpha, which we do not know. And thousands of inflationary scenarios can be classified by one number. You don't need encyclopedia of inflationary scenarios, which recently produced by some French people, but French love to produce encyclopedia. You see, second thing, because everything what we observe refers to this short interval of time, you should not be crazy and assume that something ridiculous happening there. Of course, the level of craziness has no bounds. Okay, I can also imagine that, for instance, the people who draw these potentials, they are just my imagination. And okay, if I am solipsist, you will never prove me that you exist. You see? So there should be the level, certain level of reasonability. Now, what all this goes about? You see, we have the picture of the universe, how it was evolving in past. Here we are, 13.7 billion years after creation of the whole universe. You see that in Soviet Union, in Stalin time, it was even prohibited to mention about expanding universe. I do not know why, but okay, perhaps all these guys thought that 13 billion years is not enough to build communism. I have no idea. And the first paper on cosmology in Soviet Union was published after 5th of March 1953. As you know, a remarkable date when in all cinemas in Moscow there was showing the movie The Dream Was Realized. It's not a joke. It's actually, in fact, was a movie which Romanians produced about some peasant who entered this kolkhoz or whatsoever. No, people were really in panic. I have recently read these papers. Now universe today looks very complicated, right? There is gentleman, but you have also direct photograph of the universe, how it looked like when it was not 13 billion years old, but when it was just 300,000 years old. And this direct photograph, which we obtain, is like this one. You can see here small inhomogeneities, okay, just fraction of the percent, variation of density, energy density from one place to the other, fraction of the percent. If you had this picture, then you know how after that structure could be formed. You see? Why? Because here gravity acts like gravity, okay, and there is gravitational instability, which I could characterize in a very simple way. Rich gets even richer, and poor gets more poor. So the places where there was more matter, they bring more matter there. And as a result, we form all these structures which we see today. And there is no, in principle, problem, big problem to relate these two pictures. But the question was, what is the origin of this picture of the universe where different colors correspond just variation of the temperature by fraction of the percent? You see? And here you could see different colors and you could see embryons of the galaxies. You see? So, and then, okay, many years ago, 5 minutes, then I have to skip joke from Kabbalah. It's impossible. Maybe you shouldn't count Kabbalah story for me. Okay. Because it's real story, okay, which I got, that God, when he was bored, he decided to create something nice. Then he decided to create something nice, and then he was in trouble because God was everywhere. Then God shrinked himself to the point and then produced something outside, expanded and found himself in very boring universe. Nothing was happening there. It's not specified in Kabbalah. What was it? Okay, de Sitter, anti-de Sitter, Minkowski space, but was boring. Nothing was changing. Then he showed a little bit, again shrink, but before shrinking, he distributed some garbage around, which, as we know today, were quantum fluctuation, expanded and found himself in a nice universe which was evolving. Now, and this idea in Kabbalah, I gave references for those who are interested, is characterizing Kabbalah only by their breaking could the divine configuration be perfected. There should be always imperfectness for complete perfectness. Some little imperfectness. And in this case, who is the person who discovered this imperfectness of quantum mechanics was Heisenberg. And we wanted to use this thing for producing perturbation. Now, okay, so then we realized that we need this stage of earlier domination of dark energy. And we came with some theory which had predictions, but because I have no time, I skip most of the predictions, the predictions. One was that the universe was flat, the other was that inhomogeneity should be adiabatic, which I explained here. Now I have no time to explain. Don't worry, 2 minutes, yeah, three. Wait a minute, but when did I begin? 22, 25, so 10 minutes, okay, good. Very good. Now, that inhomogeneities should be Gaussian. What does it mean, this thing? When you change intensity of this photograph, you still can recognize the girl. But if you don't want to recognize her, you spoil all correlation between phases. So it's the most democratic perturbation which one could imagine. And the last thing was what is called spectral index of perturbation because you could predict the spectrum there. And you could find out that the amplitude of inhomogeneities was growing very little to the largest scales. And moreover, I was insisting on this prediction. Okay, here quotes from the papers which I was writing before measurements were done. And this prediction, okay, like 0.96 spectral index, is coming from the formula which directly relates galactic scale, so it's megaparsec, with the typical scale of CMB. This is the only formula which contains simultaneously gravitational constant and Planck constant and was verified in physics. So it's real quantum gravity. Now, so you have prediction. Now you have two verifies. All of them were in contradiction, and then I will show movie and I will finish with conclusion, okay? So there was a set of experiments, hundreds of experiments, which were done on the ground, but the main mission was space mission. Okay, here I want to stress this cosmic background explorer, which finally has seen these seeds for the galaxies from which the whole life was originated. After that, resolution of the things was improved very much with WMAP, Wilkinson Microwave Anisotropy Probe experiment. And, okay, 2009, they were launched Planck satellite. You see, this is compared the team of WMAP with the team of Planck satellite, where they had 9 frequencies, et cetera, and then this launch. I want movie. Oh, now it's movie, real movie, it's not Hollywood. It's actually the launch of this Planck satellite, which I have shown, which happened in 2009. Okay, and this satellite went 1.5 million kilometers away from us and was covering the whole sky 5 times. There was many frequencies after that. They got this picture, cleaned from the dirt, and got this pristine picture of the universe, how it looked like when it was 300,000 years old. And here you can clearly see the seeds of the galaxies. If you want to compare how good is this picture with the previous experiment, you can compare. As I say, normally camera, I mean COBE, produced in Soviet Union compared to Japanese camera. You see, now, if you take now predictions, okay, the predictions, okay, for this perturbation, use astrophysical data, and you draw some curve which characterizes all these observations, this would be theoretical curve, okay, which has only one free parameter. Otherwise, actually, you don't need astrophysics. People call it wrongly 6-parameter. Now, take this picture and extract the same curve from there without forgetting about theory. And what you will get? You will get these points. These are experimental points. And now, put them together. Bingo! No comments, as CNN normally writes. It's clear that it could not be better. There are other curves measuring polarization. And then, finally, there is conclusion. Okay, it was proven that universe at the given moment of time has Euclidean geometry. So if you will take 3 faraway galaxies that make triangles and the sum of angles 180 degrees with this unbelievable accuracy. Perturbations, adiabatics, Gaussian, and moreover, spectral index, okay, 0.96, which is given by the formula which involves gravitation and Planck constant, is confirmed to be right with the accuracy 8 sigma. 8 sigma when you can quietly give your hand to be cut it if you are wrong, roughly speaking. Even head, I would say. 5 sigma is already enough for him. So, conclusion. You now can read conclusion. So, I think general relativity, first of all, it doesn't care too much about particle physics, thanks to Mr. Einstein and causality principle. It was proven up to the scale 10 minus 27 centimeter, which is billion times smaller than what people reached on accelerator. And up to the scale 10-28 centimeters. It's the most universally proved theory, non-perturbative. And second thing, okay, for your soul, that we all originated from quantum fluctuations, so there is nothing special about us. Thank you very much.